E aí, pessoal, beleza? Vamos iniciar a série aí, Life is Strange, Before the Storm. Né? Ela é antes da tempestade, né? Antes do Life is Strange normal. Vamos embora. Deixa eu ver as configurações. FPS alto, alta resolução. Eu gosto de resolução. Aplicar. Tá. Áudios e legendas. Idioma das legendas português do Brasil. Idioma das legendas. Grande. Colocar um pouquinho mais no canto. Não tanto. Para não atrapalhar as legendas. Beleza. Vamos lá. Episódio 1, Despertar.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Vamos mudar para FPS alto.
No trespassing? No way.
Essa Chloe é toda revoltada.
Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Olha o jeito que ela abre.
You're always blaming everyone else.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home. Now, what to draw?
Não produzimos drogas.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
To convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Usa argumentos e insultos para convencer alguém a fazer o que você quer.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Don't sleep. It's for the weak.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense! Oh, shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? Sober up, girl. You're missing the show. Damon Merrick again? Who is this guy?
No.
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute. Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. All right, it's not gonna take any more than an hour to do it.
$20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine, $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. If you don't have $20, beat it.
Still a dick.
No.
That dog is fierce.
That's exactly what we need, thank you. Yeah, I mean, they're gonna sell...
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday. Reveal less. Yes, please. Reminds me of the way I make important life choices. Classy. No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
That would help.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No, 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 no! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like 200 bucks. Holy shit! I'm rich!
Alopra.
Nothing sadder than a neglected bong. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you.
Bitch!
All right, mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Attitude. We're not done.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
As consequências que vai ter de pegar.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Rowan, wakey wakey, edgy bakey.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now.
Terrible news, my fellow Argonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors.
Just ask Steve Jobs.
Safety violations they've suffered this year. Tried a near-death experience eating there. Let us know.
Adapt or die. Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated. Fun fact, shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. I was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. I really should get going. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Tinta pra cabelo.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. Yeah, that really makes me want to hurt Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better. Nah. The heart can only take so much. It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
Chloe, get down here now.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. I might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
We're already supporting one. Thanks. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad. Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that. Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Crap. I forgot David's keys. That's probably worth at least 10 push-ups.
Das Buch hatte das Schäfs.
I made that ashtray for Mom's keys only.
Cinzeiro Sopas. Onde que tá essas chaves? Ah, tá aqui.
Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I'd better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Do you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? This used to hang in the living room. Guess it's ancient history now. Mom's been cleaning again. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire. Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10. If it's in my garage, it gets my special treatment. What message does David really need to hear? Got it. Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
I
little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Mas essa menina é cheia de marra.
Fine.
Okay, vamos aceitar.
Whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one. But thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot, uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Then I hope you're a better plumber than you are a mechanic.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
Leave Mom out of this. This is about you and me and you being an asshole.
I was in the army. You will respect me.
You're not my father. You're not even on the same planet as my father.
My job is to make sure you and your mother have a safe and peaceful home.
Do I come to your place of employment and... Oh, that's right. You don't have one.
If you were a man,
It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished.
Rebel Dads.
Country music? I'd love this song. I just call to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight oil again. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This...
This isn't right.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything. Hello, Black Hal.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you wanna go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Hey.
Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now. The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole. Students at Blackwell have this herd instinct to glom up into little groups, like sheep. And if you just want to be alone, you get labeled like some dangerous outsider. Just like any other prison. Except now the prison follows you wherever you go, thanks to social media. I can't believe Rachel posted a photo of the two of us together last night. Am I still an outsider if I'm hanging out with Rachel Amber now? And what does it mean that hanging out was so awesome? Does that make me just the same as every other student here? Nah, fuck that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Principal Wells.
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Tell what, Victoria?
It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook! I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh. Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
Olha o jeito que a mulher anda. Não segurei aqui não. Ah, tá ali.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet.
$5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
What do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join her game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Are you insulting me in some obscure nerd way?
Think about it. An elf? Like, skinny and kind of weird, but also a barbarian, so, like, really angry.
In other words, Chloe Price.
Wow, you two are a riot.
All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes...
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
It's tent time.
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
You heard me. Let's do the boss battle.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural, severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
I say something really encouraging to Elamon.
Like what?
Yeah. Like what?
Shit. Why is being nice so hard?
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to, stand up taller than you ever were.
You just cut off my feet.
Elamon feels inspired. He summons the strength necessary to crawl away from Durgaron. Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn, but you don't do enough damage to kill him.
What an asshole!
He laughs, then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die painfully.
So mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man. If you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
What have you got here? Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back.
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Want to take this elsewhere, guys?
The mute speaks?
Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Back off, as in go away. No one's interested in your crap.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size, which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat!
You shut the fuck up!
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Beleza, pessoal. Depois a gente continua aí.
If I'm late to class, that's just one more excuse for Mom to sick David on me.